about this is columnist for the National Review, David French. David, great to see you.
Well, thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
And we appreciate you. You wrote an article. Explain what you mean by traditional masculine virtues and what that means. And you say you have no problem, by the way, with the Gillette ad.
Right. I mean, the Gillette ad was maybe a little heavy-handed, but at the end of the day, it was saying bad things are bad. I mean, it was against sexual harassment. It was against bullying. No, what I'm more concerned about is there has been a real move to say, and the American Psychological Association has been leading this charge with new guidelines dealing with men and boys, to say that traditional masculinity, that's the word they use, was harmful to men. And they were talking about things like the adventurousness, the risk-taking, the teaching boys to be strong or teaching boys to be stoic, that those things were harmful to men. And I dispute that strongly. In fact, many men and boys want to be like that. They want to be strong. They want to be stoic, and by that means not blown and tossed too much by emotions. And to teach against that is actually harmful.
Well, how do you know that, though? Because I think it needs to be a choice. And when you say, here's a quote from the article, how many older men have you met in your life who have said, I wish I was less tough, was less able to provide for my family, and more dependent on the whims of my emotions. Do you ever feel, though, that it's kind of society that's moving boys into believing that they have to? Because isn't, let's say, you're a stay-at-home dad, and that's what makes you happy, and you're providing in that way, shouldn't that be okay as well?
Well, it's absolutely okay, and we should absolutely love people who have a different view of what masculinity should be. But when you have the American Psychological Association saying traditional masculinity is harmful, that blanket statement, when the reality is, I think a lot of men and boys are struggling in large part because the way they want to live, that schools and workplaces are oriented against the way that they want to live and the way that they want to be. Traditional masculinity hurts them, yes.
I guess the way I see it is harmful or hurtful if there is no other choice, meaning they're ostracized for not acting a certain way, or, oh, you're too sensitive, toughen up, get back in the game. So that's how I would interpret that. I only have a couple seconds left. I wish I had more. What's your response to that?
I believe we should be compassionate and tolerant towards people. But at the same time, sometimes boys do need to be told to toughen up and get back in the game. And they want to be the person that they become as a result of toughening up. And that's one of the challenges of raising a young man.
I respectfully disagree, David. I wish we had an hour on this. I could talk to you with the panel. Let's do it in the future. David French, we appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.